Alright, welcome back to another MCreator Procedures tutorial. So today what we're going to be covering is the templates as well as how to import and export procedures for later use so you don't need to worry about having to copy over things multiple times. I constantly use this when I need to bring certain parts of procedures between different things. Maybe I want to separate a procedure and lower the amount of blocks in a procedure so I can save performance and stuff like that. What I do is I usually just export the part that I want to and then use a call block to call in the part that I am basically shifting out. So we'll get to that in the future. Don't worry about that part. But right now I just want to show you the export and import system as well as procedure templates. So let's go ahead and if you go to the top here, you'll see the export procedure and import procedure. These are your two buttons to export and import. Anything connected to this main green block, even if you had other procedures or conditions or stuff connected to here, this will all count as one export. If you just have something that you don't want to attach to or export, you can always drag it so it's not attached to this group over here. So in cases of you having multiple script, maybe you have a condition or whatever, then if you want not this block to be taken into consideration, you can just drag that part off and then it will only export these things. Now with that being said, if you export the file, you can export it to a PTPL file, which is basically the procedure file that MCreator uses to determine it, what kind of file it is. So you can basically save it, and then to import it, you can do the exact same thing. You just click on import, locate your file, and then you can import it, and it'll drag it to the bottom of the list of all the procedures. So if you have a really lengthy procedure, it's going to be way at the bottom underneath all of everything. So one of the things that you might want to do is actually right click and go collapse block when you have a whole bunch of script in an if statement or something like that, and then that will make it go closer to the top of the list. Just a fun tip for you. So now that we have a file here, what we can do is we can go ahead and we can use this in the template. So to do this, there's a couple ways you can go about doing it. You can go to the file and then preferences, and then scroll down to procedure templates, and then you can go ahead and click on the add procedure template, select the file location, and select the procedure that you want to add, and this will add it to the list. Now the name of the procedure will be this part right here where the text of the file name is. So if you have a procedure that is named one or whatever, I suggest naming it something that you can remember it by, because it will be imported into the template list. So we're going to save this, and I'm not sure if it will we require to restart. Yeah, we require to restart. So we'll basically save our procedure, and then we'll reboot MCreator. And what will happen is we can go open our procedure, and then what we'll do is we'll go to procedure templates. Now, all these are basically the lists of procedure templates that are built in, but your procedure files that are you basically saved are going to be at the very bottom of the list. So in this case, we have that height one that's now there, and we can import that and it will keep everything the same. So if you wanted to remove a procedure template, what you can do is you can go back to the list and then select your file, and then you can go ahead and remove. You can also open the templates folder, and this will open up the folder where all your procedure templates are stored. So in this case, I can just remove it and then click save and then reboot, because most likely this is going to be still in here at the moment. So we're going to reboot and then it should be gone. So if we go back to our procedure templates and scroll down to the bottom after rebooting, you can see we don't have the height one anymore. Today's assignment for you guys is to export a procedure that you want to. It doesn't need to be anything that works or anything like that. You just get used to the import and export. And once you get the import and export figured out, then what you can do is you can start using the preferences and importing procedures that you want to keep or just experiment with for the time being, and then call them from the list in here. So hopefully this will help you guys with the learning how to use the templates and stuff like that. It's not too hard, one of the basic things, but it does come in handy when you need to use more advanced script and when you're breaking things off into smaller procedures and stuff like that. So it's a definitely a useful tool to actually have when you start working with larger procedures and stuff like that. So outside of that, if you are new to my channel, don't forget to subscribe, comment down below, rate the video, and I will see you guys next time. Thanks for watching.